request all the faculty members to have your notebook, pen, and some calculators in hand, so that it will be simpler for you to follow the calculations and the problems when I'm teaching you. Let us start now. And in the previous session, at the end, someone wrote in the chat box regarding stiffness calculation of far end hinged. Am I right? Are you available here? Are you there? The one who posted the question regarding stiffness calculation, far end hinged.
I think he has not joined yet.
Yeah. I hope the screen is visible to everybody.
Yes, sir.
So this is the question asked, how to estimate the stiffness for beam hinged at both ends. Suppose if I am interested at this joint, if the far end is hinged, how to estimate the stiffness is was asked in the chat box. Same slope deflection equation, just apply the conditions. Like there is no settlement, there is no external load applied, so no fixed end moments. Solve these two equations. You know that bending moment at this point B is zero because it is hinged end. So use that condition here. If this is zero, this will get vanished. 2 theta A is equal to minus theta A. So theta B will be equal to minus theta A by 2. Substituting this back to MAB, we get MAB as 3 EI theta A by L. Let us start with the second session, session 3, regarding this moment distribution method to solve the problems. Please note this question. So I hope you remember the stepwise procedure to solve the moment distribution method. This beam is of prismatic cross section having same EI all along its length, subjected to uniformly distributed load of 3 kN per meter over the span 5 meters and having a point load acting at a distance of 3 meters from the left end. So first let us solve this problem using moment distribution method. So what is the first step to do in the moment distribution method?
Finding fixed end moment.
Huh?
Finding fixed end moment.
Finding the fixed end moments. Very good. So the steps are finding fixed end moments, distributing the unbalanced moment, and then carry over of distributed moment. Then finally, complete cycle, we have to estimate the total moment. So let me just explain you pictorially. Later we will solve the same using tabular column. So table format I will teach you second. First, I will just show you pictorially what it represents. So the first step, find out the fixed end moment. So there are few loading for which closed form expressions are available to estimate the fixed end moments. For example, we have seen in the previous class, if it is subjected to UDL, there is a fixed expression, and if it is subjected to a point load, there is a fixed expression. You estimate the fixed end moments and just write it along with its sign convention. For our case, anticlockwise moment is positive and clockwise moment is negative. So I just wanted to represent here, when I am giving clockwise moment here, I need not have to write here negative, but to make you realize the sign convention I am writing here. Second step, find out the unbalanced moment. So you know that end A and C are fixed in the given problem, whereas end B is having hinged support. That means it is allowed to rotate. So the given degree of freedom is the rotation at end B. So initially restrain the rotation at end B, find out the fixed end moments. Once you get the fixed end moments, for example, if you have the calculator, I shall show you the expressions once again for the fixed end moments along with its direction. It is given for an UDL, WL square by 12 this side and this side. So for the given loading, W is 3, L is 5. Then you can substitute the values here. Similarly, you can do the fixed end moments for this also. P A square B by L square and P B square A by L square. So given is 3 kilonewton per meter, 5 meter and 10 kilonewton. So estimate the fixed end moments. So joint B, I need to allow it to rotate because there is degree of freedom here, right? So first I should find out the unbalanced moment at the joint B. So if I add this to 7.2 minus 6.25, I get 0.95 as the unbalanced moment acting in the anticlockwise direction. Now I have to balance this moment. That means I have to allow the beam to rotate, and also that rotating moment that is induced in the members should be in equilibrium with the unbalanced moment. So I am going to take this moment itself as a balancing moment, that is minus 0.95. So we have seen that distributed moment is minus moment at any member is the minus distribution factor times of the fixed end moment. So I have to balance that moment. Here itself I am balancing it by just changing its sign as minus 0.95. Then the other step is now to find out the stiffness, bending stiffness of this member BA and BC. If the far end is fixed, for example, my choice of interest is joint B, because this is what is having the degree of freedom, right? So from B, the far end at A is fixed. Also from B, the far end at C is fixed. In that sense, the bending stiffness of this member is 4EI by L. That is KBA is 4EI by L and KBC is 4EI by L. So what is the distribution factor? Distribution factor is the stiffness of that member divided by the total stiffness of the members meeting at a single joint. So I have two members here. So 2 times of 4EI by L, that is summation of that. Then one member 4EI by L. So it will be totally 0.5. I get distribution factor for this beam as well as this beam. Estimation of distribution factor is clear. Faculty members, is it clear? I'm unable to hear. Actually, I cannot see the chat box. You can just respond by just turning on your mic. You can directly converse with me when I'm teaching the problem. Then the next step is, this is the distributed moment. That is, this is the distribution factor 0.5 for this beam, 0.5 for this beam. That is BA distribution factor is 0.5, BC distribution factor is 0.5. So 0.5 into 0.95 is minus 0.475. This 0.5 into 0.95 is minus 0.475. So these are the distributed moments. Now I have to carry over the effect of this distributed moment to the end of this member. That is carrying over the effect of this to the other end. That is always half. If the end is fixed. When the far end is fixed, the carryover factor is half. So half of this will be distributed to the edges. Then the total member moment, total moment will be first step, fixed end moment, then the distributed moment and the carryover moment. You have to add everything except 2 and 3, which is taken care of in the fourth step directly by distributing the moment. So 2 and 3 is basically not shown directly, whereas 1, 4 and 5 will give us the required results. You sum the moments at all the edges and you can see that the moment at the joint B is 0, which is satisfied. Pictorial representation is clear to everybody? Faculty members?
Yes, ma'am.
So now let us move on to the same thing in the tabular format. So when you go for the tabular format, the first step is to estimate the distribution factor. So I already told, for joint B, the far end is fixed at A and also far end is fixed at C. So the relative stiffness, which is I by L, if the far end is fixed, and which is 3 by 4th I by L, if the far end is pinned. We know that BA and BC have far end fixed. So the relative stiffness is I by L and I by L, where the length of the member is 5 meter. So I by 5, I by 5. So total summation of this stiffness is 2 I by 5. And the distribution factor is KI divided by the summation of k, ki divided by the summation of k, you get the distribution factor 0.5. So in the given table, like this problem, you write joint A, joint B, joint C, and the comments. In joint A, there is no distribution factor, whereas joint B, there is distribution factor of 0.5 and 0.5, and joint C, it is 0. So the first step is to write the fixed end moments. So you write down the fixed end moments with the sign clockwise moment negative and anticlockwise moment positive. So the first step is completed. And the second to fourth step, which we have seen in the figure, we are going to see it as balancing moment itself directly. Like 7.2 minus 6.25 will be 0.95, which is a positive value. We have to change a sign, which is minus 0.95, into distribution factor times. You have to write it here. So 7.2 minus 6.25 will give you 0.95 into 0.5, and its negative value should be written here and here. Then balancing the distributed moment is completed here. Next step is carryover of moment. So take half of this here, half of this here, and try to sum this and see whether the equilibrium is satisfied for the force quantity at joint B. If that is satisfied, then the one complete cycle is completed and the solution is obtained. Then you can draw the bending moment diagrams for the estimated values. Is the tabular format clear to everybody?
Yes, ma'am.
So yes, ma'am. Next problem, can you please solve along with me? Is it possible? Everybody, can you solve the next problem along with me? The same problem, let us now take out this fixity into a hinge support like this. So we have now 2 degrees of freedom where it can also rotate as well as it can also rotate. So what is the first step? The same problem with, instead of fixed support at C, now let us take the hinged support at C also. So the fixed end moments will remain same, isn't it? This is the second problem, which is the just changing the support condition. So you have this beam free to rotate and you have 1 degree of freedom free to rotate here. So two things are here. So first step, fixed end moment, next step, distribution of balancing moment, and then carry over of distributed moment, and then get the total moment at the end of the cycle. So get the distribution factor. This is joint B. Please note here very carefully. From joint B, if you see far end A is fixed, whereas far end C is hinged. So the relative stiffness for B, A is? The relative stiffness for B, A is?
2/5.
I by 5. What about BC? Relative stiffness for member BC. Please respond. This problem is you have to solve. So what is the relative stiffness for member BC? Far end is hinged. If the far end is hinged, the relative stiffness of the fixed member will be reduced by 3/4. In that case, the relative stiffness for member BC is Are you understanding?
Yes, ma'am. 3/4 I into I by 5.
3/4 I/5. Very good. So these two are given. So the summation of these two is 7/4 I/5. So the distribution factor is this divided by this will give you 4/7, and this divided by this will give you 3/7. So for distribution factor for BA is 4/7 and BC is 3/7. Are we having distribution factor for C or not? C is also like point B, but it does not have the continuation on the other side. So we need to estimate the distribution factor for joint C also. Please note, it is also like point B where you have left side and right side continuous support, whereas point C is continuous on its left side and but it is curtained at the same location. In that case also we have distribution, and we have distribution factor from joint C. So from C to B, always when there is continuous end, it is assumed to be fixed only. Please note, there is continuity in the sense it is almost nearer to fixed only. So the far end is again going to be fixed. Relative stiffness of this member KCB will be I/5. Whereas to the right side nothing is there, so KI by total K will be the same value. In that case the distribution factor will be 1. Is this clear? Or do I need to repeat it?
Can I repeat, ma'am?
You want me to repeat? Rather, I would do it and show you. This table is for joint B. Now let us do the same table for joint C. Let me just copy the same slide and give it in the next slide. Let us take this joint B, joint C. So this will be member, please tell me. CB, right? To the left of C, it is CB. Am I right?
Yes, ma'am.
To the right of C, there is nothing, so don't do anything there. Please understand, when the support is continuous, and your point of interest is C, if the far end is continuous, it should be considered as fixed. If that is the case, the relative stiffness with respect to C to B is I by L. Are you getting this? Are you getting this?
Yes, ma'am.
Whereas there is no continuity on the other side, therefore this will be nothing. So what is the total stiffness at joint C? What all members are joining, I have to add it together. So only one member is joining, that is I/5. So KI by total K will be 1 here, and there is nothing here, so no members, no. Zero. Is this clear?
Yes, ma'am.
So now we know from the previous slide this is for joint B. This is for joint C. 0 at end A, 4 by 7 at end B from here, 3 by 7 at the other end BC here. So I am writing BC in one column, AB in one column, and then CB in the same column. Whereas after C there is nothing, so I am not writing anything. So the fixed end moments of these members are written here. Then the next step is we have to distribute the balancing moment. So what is the value? 7.2 minus 6.25. I hope you all have the calculator in your hand. You have the calculator? Otherwise, it will be difficult for you to understand. 0.95. So 0.95 is the unbalanced moment. So negative sign of that should be distributed to the joint. So 0.95 into 4 by 7 is how much?
Hmm? 0.54 0.54 0.54 ma'am.
Yeah, so when you add these two, that is the unbalanced moment. You have to convert it into balanced moment, so that will become negative. Then that balanced moment should be distributed according to the stiffness of the member, which is based on the distribution factor. So 4 by 7 times of 0.95 is 0.54. And since it is a balancing moment, so minus of that value is taken here. And similarly, 4 by 3 by 7 of minus 0.95 is how much? Next, again, when you did that here, similarly, you have to balance the moment at joint C also. Basically, if it is a hinged support, the moment at point C should be. If it is a hinged support, the moment at point C should be.
Zero.
So I should not get minus 4.8 there. So I should completely ignore this value. It should not be minus 4.8. So completely I add the same value here. So this is the distribution of balancing moment. 1 into 4.8, negative of that is 4.8. And then next step is carry over half of 0.54 here and half of 0.41 here and half of 0.48 here. And this is the carry over moments. Now, you can see this joint. Again, there is unbalanced force 0 and 2.4. This is not balanced yet. So I need to again calculate the balancing moment. So 0 plus 2.4, which is 2.4. I should consider the negative value of that. So minus 2.4. Minus 2.4 into 4 by 7, how much? Minus 2.4 into 3 by 7, how much?
Minus 1.37.
Yeah, that is fine. Next one, into 3 by 7.
$1.028.
Okay, around $1.03, let us take. Next, at end C, again there is one more unbalanced moment, minus 0.21. Carryover factor is 1, so negative of that value into 1 will give you 0.21. Now again, you have to carry over the moments. So half of this here, half of this here, and half of this here. Far ends will be taking half the moments, right? So we are doing the half here and here. Then we have to check whether we are having still unbalanced moment here. Yeah, we are having still. So 0.11 is the unbalanced moment again. So 0.11, negative of that is minus 0.11 into 4 by 7, how much?
Minus 0.06.
Yeah. Similarly, minus 0.11 into 3 by 7, how much?
Minus 0.047.
Almost 0.05. Then, at this location, moment should not be there. So, to nullify this, plus 0.52. So, let us take the total value and see whether this equilibrium is satisfied or not. Otherwise, you have to continue the iteration. But you can see here, these two are almost nearer. 0.06 and 0.05. Only 0.01 is the difference. So almost the moments are getting balanced here. So let us add this and check. If you add it and check, the joint moment B, summation of joint moment B will be 0. Then it is right. It is converged. And the summation of moments at the joint C is 0. It is satisfied. Also, this is fixed to N. So you have some amount of bending moment there. Is it clear?
Clear, ma'am.
Then draw the bending moment diagram. Let us go for the problem with support settlement. So how to calculate the how to consider the effect of support settlement in the moment distribution problem that I have taught you in the previous session? How do you consider the effect of support settlement in the moment distribution method problem? How to do that? I have told you one point in the previous class regarding if there is support settlement or if there is side sway, the effect of those translations should be converted into equivalent fixed end moments and then consider that in the moment distribution method. Isn't it? Is it clear? If you are not clear, I'll explain that slide once again before starting this problem. You please tell me. Faculties, are you okay? Shall we proceed or do I need to explain that and come back here?
One participant has responded in the chat box that it is clear.
Yeah. So please unmute your mic and tell, because I cannot see the chat box. That's why.
Clear, ma'am.
See, this problem I am going to completely tell you starting from the steps that you have learnt in the previous two approaches. Previously, two problems which you have seen, it is for continuous beam without support settlement. Now we are going to see two more problems, which are with support settlement and how to estimate the bending moment and shear force, everything. The previous two problems I focused on how to conduct the moment distribution method and estimate the bending moments. Whereas in the next two problems, you will be clearly knowing the stepwise procedure to proceed with both support settlement, with the support settlement also the same procedure, without also the same procedure. Where with support settlement, additionally fixed end moments due to support settlement will come. So analyze the continuous beam by moment distribution method. Support B and C settles by 8 mm and 4 mm respectively. EI of the member is 30,000 kN meter square. Sketch the shear force diagram and bending moment diagram. So let us now first go ahead, find out the distribution factor. So we have, like previous problem, we have here one rotational degree of freedom here and one rotational degree of freedom here. So we have to have two distribution tables like this, one for BA and BC and another one for CB. Like previous problem, that will be one. I hope that is clear now. So in this problem, let us go to the joint B. Far end is fixed. So the stiffness, relative stiffness with respect to BTA will be I by L, which is I by 4. But if you go to B to C, the far end is hinged from B. If the far end is hinged, the relative stiffness is 3/4 of I by L. So 3 by 4 of I by length of this beam is 6 meter. Then sum of these two stiffnesses gives you 0.375 I, where the distribution factor for this is I by 4 divided by this, and distribution factor for this is divided by this. So you get 0.67 and 0.33. This step is clear to everybody?
Yeah, ma'am.
Ma'am, also, ma'am.
Yeah.
For BC member, why we produce 3 by 4 I by L?
Okay. What is the concept of your stiffness? If I wanted the stiffness of this joint, I apply unit rotation at this joint. Whereas the other joint will remain as it is.
Yes.
If I give unit rotation here, this end is fixed. If I apply unit rotation here, this end is hinged.
Yes.
If the far end is hinged, if I apply theta here, and what is the value of stiffness?
3 A L V.
Yeah. Then what is the relative stiffness value? 3 by 4 I by L.
Okay.
Right?
Okay. Clear.
Sorry, I came back to the other slide. So now you got it clarified?
Yes, ma'am. Yes.
Next step. Fixed end moment due to applied loading. So calculate the fixed end moment due to the loading that is applied here, which is 240 kN here and 40 kN meter for this span. So you are writing the fixed end moments by fixing the all the edges. In addition, we have now fixed end moments due to support settlement, because there is two support settlement. B settles by 8 mm, C settles by 4 mm. So we need to calculate fixed end moment due to support settlement also. So what is told to you? If any support is given displacement, opposing the displacement, moment will be generated which is 6 EI delta by L square. I hope this is clear to you. Already it is explained to you using the moment, using the slope deflection equation. So this support B is settling by around 8 mm, whereas this support C is settling by around 4 mm. Right? So this card rotation is in this direction. So the resisting moment should be in the opposing direction. If you see this card rotation, it is towards the anti-clockwise direction. Therefore, the resisting moment will be in the clockwise direction. Then, fix the signs for anti-clockwise positive and clockwise negative. So, these are the fixed end moments that are created due to support settlement. Is this clear to you?
Yes, ma'am.
Any question here? See, card rotation means you can see joining these two ends of this deflected beam. You can see this is the card rotation, which is going in the clockwise direction, whereas the resisting moment is always in the anti-clockwise direction. So you should always note the card rotation of the beam when it is undergoing the support settlement. So if I do the card rotation that is going in the clockwise direction due to the settlement, therefore the resisting moment should be opposing this. Similarly, if you see this beam, the card rotation is in the anti-clockwise direction. So your resisting moment should be in the clockwise direction. Accordingly, these two will give you positive value and these two will give you negative value. So the total fixed end moments will be summation of applied loading and fixed end moments due to support settlement. So you add it together and get the final value of the moment and you write it in the final values. This step, any question here in this step? If you know how to calculate the fixed end moment for the support settlement problem, then rest of the procedure remains the same, because you are just converting the support settlement into an equivalent fixed end moment. Once you convert it into equivalent fixed end moment, then everything will resemble similar to whatever you have done for the beams without settlement. So let us move on to the next step, which is the distribution of balancing moment. I am going to teach you one shortcut here. What is that is, your end C is actually hinged. So when it is always known to you that when it is hinged, the bending moment is always zero. So you don't need to repeat these steps by carrying over here all the time, like what we have done in the previous example. That is the stepwise procedure. Rather, you can directly nullify the effect of that moment and carry over to the inner beam. And thereafter, you need not have to worry about that at all. So this is the shortcut that way. So let us take the fixed end moments. What is given? 210 minus 30. 100 and 140. So AB, BA, BC and CB. AB is 210, BA is minus 30, BC is 100, CB is minus 140 from this figure. Next, unbalanced moment here is 100 minus 30, which is 70. Which is positive. So you have to convert it into negative value of that. So minus 70 into 0.67, you have to write here. So minus 70 into 0.33, you have to write here. Can anyone calculate and tell me? Minus 70 into 0.67.
-46.9.
Similarly, -70 into 0.33.
-23.1.
Very good. So you got these moments. Again, here you have to balance. I wanted the bending moment at the joint C zero because it is a hinged support. So positive of this value is taken, and you nullify it here itself. Next step, you carry over this effect of this moments to the far end. That means corresponding far end. Like half of this is given here, half of this is given here, and do not take the carry over of this to here, because anyway you know that you are supposed to make it zero only. So here itself you nullify and take it to this way, and thereafter you need not have to worry about it. So what is the now unbalanced moment is 0 plus 70, which is 70 again. Then the negative value of that is minus 70. Minus 70 into 0.67 will be this value, which is already the same. Minus 70 into point this value will be this one. So once the distribution of balancing moment is complete, then carry over. So carry over of this half towards here, then add it, and you will see that you will ensure the equilibrium at the joint that is already satisfied. Do you have any questions here?
No, ma'am.
Ma'am?
Yeah?
And for balancing, you want where you have to stop, ma'am? Carry over and balancing.
See, this will always end with carry over.
Okay.
The moment your two joints are B and C.
Yes, ma'am.
Joint B, moments, summation of moments at joint B should be zero. Summation of moments at joint C should be zero.
Okay.
In your case, hinge C is hinged, so definitely the moment should be zero, so you don't need to worry about it.
Okay.
But you have to ensure that joint B summation of all the moments should be zero. Are you ensuring it here?
Yes.
If not, that is the unbalanced moment, then take the distribution and then do the carryover. You got it?
Okay. Thank you.
Thank you. Now the next step is to draw the bending moment and shear force. For that, what you are supposed to do, you have to take the free body diagram of the given problem. So the given problem is this, right? Here, fixed end you replace with the fixed end moment, the moment value that you have obtained after the moment distribution. Again, here there will be moment that obtained after the distribution. And there will be reaction in the vertical direction that will be generated to oppose the vertical movement. And there will be again one opposing moment generated. So take these two beams separately, use the equilibrium equation, and find out the shear force and bending moments. Let us see that, how to do that. So let us take the first half of the beam, which is AB. It is fixed at one end. From your moment distribution table, you know that at the one end it is 163.1, at the other end it is -123.8. Take those two values here with the assumed direction of the arrow to be anti-clockwise always. Even if it is negative, you keep it anti-clockwise, because if it is positive, then it will become clockwise. So the applied load is 240 kN, and the resisting force for the supports are VAB and VBA. So what is the first equilibrium equation to solve a beam? Summation of forces along the considered X or Y direction should be zero. In your case, the axial forces in the beams are always negligible. So we are not considering any axial forces here. Then only vertical forces are transverse to the beam that is acting. So VAB plus VBA is equal to 240 kN. Then take moment about A to be 0, then 163 minus 123 minus 240 into 2 plus VBA into 4 is equal to 0. Take out the moment about this point, it's equal to 0. Solving these two equations, from this equation you get VBA, you substitute it here and you get VAB. So you got now the support moment, support reactions. So if I'm interested in the moment at the center, then take moment about the midpoint, VAB into this distance, which is clockwise, so negative, that is minus 129.8 into 2. Then there is one more moment, that is 163.1, that is anticlockwise, so I directly add it, which is equal to 96.5 is the moment that is at the center of this beam. Solving this is clear to you?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Let us now go to the next span. What is the thing? 123.8 on the left side of BC and 0 on the right side of BC. So apply the loads, that is 40 kN per meter. Apply the reactions from the supports. Then apply the bending moments from the moment distribution diagram. That is 123.8 and the other side is 0. So you have to now use the equilibrium equation for this members and find out the shear force and bending moment. So take the problem as it is, isolate it with the free body diagram, then summation of forces in the vertical direction 0. This one plus this one is equal to 40 into 6 to 40. Then moment about A equal to 0, 123 plus 6 into BCB minus 40 into 6 square by 2, from which you get VCB, substitute it here and get VBC, and now you got the shear force. Once you get the shear force, then if you want the moment at the center, then take moment about center, VBC into this, which is negative, so minus 140 into 3. There is already an anticlockwise moment, then 123.8. Then 40 into half of this distance is 3 into 3 by 2, so 40 into 3 square by 2. So totally you get the moment at the center as 118 kN meter. Is it clear? Is it clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Then you come back. You got the support moments from the moment distribution diagram. Center moment by solving the each beam for equilibrium of force quantities. And finally draw the bending moment and shear force of the given beam. From your basic mechanics, you can find out the locations of the point of contraflexure by solving the moment about some point X and making it to be 0 and get the location. Shall we move to the next problem?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am. Huh?
Yes, ma'am.
This is the continuous beam with support settlement again. A continuous beam is loaded as shown in the figure. During loading, the support B sinks by 10 mm. Determine the bending moments at the supports. Sketch the bending moment diagram. Given that I value, E value, and use moment distribution method. Now, can anyone summarize what we are supposed to do here?
First, we have to find the moments, ma'am.
First, we have to find the
moments.
Which moments?
From the joint AB.
What is the name given to that?
MAB, MBA.
No, I'm asking the first step to solve the problem is? You want to find the fixed end moments. Are you talking about that?
I'm sorry, ma'am. Sorry.
So you are talking about fixed end moments.
Yes, ma'am.
So you have here support settlement problem. So how many fixed end moments you will find out? Also note that this beam is having 2 times of I and this beam is having 1 time of I. So that has to be reflected. Can anyone say the steps till now, whatever we have seen?
Ma'am, but it's far end is fixed, it means 4A I by L, ma'am. From with respect to support A, B, BA is 4A I by L. 4 into 8 and 8.
No, I am asking not the step that is given here. Okay. I am asking the overall steps that has to be carried out in order to solve this problem. First step is finding the distribution moment, distribution factor. Next step is finding out the fixed end moments. Please note, it is beam with support settlement. So while calculating the fixed end moments, you have to take 2 parts. One is for external loading and another one is for support settlement and get the total fixed end moments. Then the third step, you have to go back to the table and start doing the balancing distribution of balancing moment and carryover factor and finally get the bending moments at the edges and ensure that the equilibrium equation is satisfied for the considered joint. Basically, when you solve this slope deflection equation, you take the summation of moment at one particular joint to be zero explicitly. But in moment distribution method, you will satisfy that alone indirectly by doing the iteration. So that is the key step which you need to remember when to stop the iteration or not. Once that is completed, whatever the unknown force, unknown moment quantities that you have got, apply it to the given problem and find out the shear force and bending moment by drawing the free body diagram of the given beam separately for each beam and then finally complete the bending moment and shear force diagram. So now you can explain me directly here. The member B, I have 2 degrees of freedom here, one is at B and one is at C, which is rotation at B and rotation at C. Then I need to have 2 different tables, one is for B, one is for C. And I have told you a shortcut for C because C is already pinned, so moment is going to be zero there. So you don't need to find the distribution table for C, whereas for B you need to find out. So for BA, it is far end fixed. Far end fixed means what is the relative stiffness value? What is the relative stiffness value for the far end fixed?
4 by L.
Yeah, 4A by L in terms of relative stiffness, I by L.
I by L.
I by L, that's one, that's I.
Right? I by L, right? So what is the value of I for the beam AB?
2I,
right? So it will be 2I by L. So that is the value given here. So what is the value for the far end hinged?
3 by 4 IL.
3 by 4 I by L. So that is this value. So the summation of these two will be this, and the distribution factor is this value divided by this writing here, this value divided by this writing over here. Now again I am going to tell you one more trick that I will tell you when we come to the moment distribution table. Then the next step is fixed end moments due to applied loading. So for the applied external load, find out the fixed end moments and write down here. Then fixed end moment due to support settlement. Now joint B is undergoing support settlement of 10 mm. So the card rotation is this way, that is clockwise. So the resistance should be in the anti-clockwise moment. And for this card rotation is in anti-clockwise. So the resisting moment in the clockwise direction. So write down the anti-clockwise moment positive and clockwise moment negative here. So the total fixed end moment is, you have to add everything and write down the value here. Now you come back to here. Suppose if you have a problem with hinge at the end, which is going to be always zero. In the first step, we have seen that we can keep continuing to bring it over as carryover of moment and we can solve it, like I will show you. In this question, what did you do? This end again zero, but you keep on taking this factor, carryover factor, and you at last made it zero. Rather than doing this waste of time, in the previous problem, I told you, you directly bring it carryover here and do not bring this value here and leave it as it is. Anyway, it is going to be zero. Rather, you can also do one thing. You can nullify the effect of this before starting the moment distribution table. Let us see that, how to do it in this problem. Are you clear? This is the third way, simpler way I am saying you.
Yes,
ma'am.
In this way, what I am saying, again this end is going to be hinged. Definitely this moment should not come. So before starting the balancing and all, I will first write down the fixed end moments, 22, minus 10, minus 8 and minus 16. I wrote here, joint C should not have any moment, so plus 16 alone I will do. And if I add these two, definitely I'll get zero. So that is balancing moment. I don't need to hereafter worry about bringing carryover factor to C. But when I'm balancing the effect of this, definitely there will be half the moment distributed to the far end of this member. So you should bring the distributed factor of this here, that is carryover of this, half of that you have to bring. Then you have to add with this existing unbalanced moment. When you add this, ultimately what you get is minus 10. And zero, and you bring this directly over here and this is going to be zero. Is it clear?
Clear, ma'am.
So this is total balancing moment. Here after only I am going to start the iteration. I have not started doing the distribution of balancing moment. I just wanted to ignore the hinged support and I wanted to make it zero. So what we are supposed to do here, first make this zero by adding it, and the effect of this distributed towards the far end using the carryover factor, that is half of this, and add it with the unbalanced fixed end moments and get the final values here. This plus this is 0, this is minus 10, this is 22, and this is always 0. Now minus 10 plus 0 is minus 10, negative of that is 10. 10 into 5.7 is 5.7, 10 into 4.43 is 4.3. So the next step is carry over of this over the left, whereas I need not have to do the carry over because this is already satisfied. So you start adding and check whether you are able to satisfy the equilibrium at the joint. When I added, it is found that joint B is in equilibrium, joint C is in equilibrium, and it is satisfied. So these are the end moments that are finally estimated from the given problem. Is this clear? If you don't have any question, then I'll move on to the next. Again, to find the shear force and bending moment. So the given problem is this. Fixed end moment, that means the degree of freedom here will be 5. If I remove this support and if I explain it in terms of now, instead of fixed end moment, what is the free body diagram for the fixed end moment? What is the free body diagram for the fixed end? I have one horizontal arrow, but summation of forces along horizontal direction 0, there will not be any horizontal force developed, so that will be 0. Whereas here, again there will be a moment acting, and that support again can be replaced with so this is the free body diagram after getting the loading and bending moments. So you got the end moments here, here, and here it is 0. You need to find out the shear force, this value, and this value for the applied load of 8 Newton here and 3 kilonewton per meter here. For that only, what we are doing, we are isolating this into one beam separately, this beam separately, and then drawing it like this. I hope you understand now how you are getting this figure. Are you getting?
Yes.
Huh? Only when you draw the free body diagram you can solve for equilibrium, otherwise it will be very difficult. So we need to draw the free body diagram with all the possible unknown forces, unknown reactions, and known forces and known moments, everything. Now we know the end moments, we need to know only the reactions. For that beam which I have showed you now, this is the free body. Now we are going to take this half beam separately and this half beam separately and find out the reaction for this and this and then for this and this. Definitely it will be in equilibrium because we are going to satisfy the equilibrium equation at each joints. So summation of forces in vertical direction zero. VAB plus VBA is equal to 3 into their entire length, so you get this value. Then moment about A equal to 0, you find out the unknown VB, A, and then you substitute here and get VAB, and you got the two unknown forces, that is the reactions. Then using that, you find out the moment at the center. This effect into distance, this moment effect and the loading into the distance will give you the moment at the center. Similarly, you take the other half of the beam, use the force equilibrium, use the moment equilibrium and calculate the unknown reaction forces. Once you finalize that, you come back and estimate the moment at the center. In this case, it is only one component here, so VCB into this distance will give you the moment at center, which is 5.8. 2.9 into 2 will give me 5.8 kilonewton meter. Use that values to draw the shear force and bending moment diagrams. Any questions till now? Are you having any questions related to solving the moment distribution problems?
No, ma'am, it's clear.
So if you have any questions, you can discuss with me. Otherwise, we can wind up the session. And you can start with your tutorial session. Ma'am?
Yes, ma'am.
Till now, I didn't get any questions from student.
Okay, ma'am.
Sorry, student. So since I was teaching students, so I'm remembering that you all have students. I'm sorry. Is it fine? It is completed. There is no much questions from other faculty members. Hello?
Yeah, I hope there are no questions. I think it's much clear for them.
Okay. So do you want me to give more explanation? I think this is sufficient for them to understand the basic. That's why beyond that I didn't give. If you don't have any more questions, then we can wind up the session, ma'am.
Yes, madam. So on behalf of all the participants present here, I'd like to thank Dr. Tamil Rasi for his introductory section on moment distribution method. And also to, she took a few problems on the analysis of continuous beams on moment distribution method. So I think the participants enjoyed your session well. So they understood the session also. So thank you very much, madam, for your acceptance for this particular FDP program as a resource person and shared your expertise on this. Thank you, madam.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you, everybody. Thank you for listening to the lecture. If you have any questions or anything, you can just write an email to me. It is available in the website. Thank you.
Thank you,
Sure, ma'am. Thank you.
There is a group photo session now.
Yeah. Again. Thank you.
Thank you all.
Thank you.